next thing you know, by now, a huge problem is heading our way. An emergency meeting is being called at our usual place immediately. Free bagels.
I've made a shocking discovery. I need you to get me in touch with NASA immediately.
Well, NASA and I aren't really on speaking terms these days.
Well, that'll change. When you tell them that the moon is out of orbit.
There's no need to panic.
I'm not crazy!
Why are they lying about all this?
It's too late to stop.
You knew all this was happening before NASA.
You're the unidentified source?
Oh, yes.
We're dealing with an intelligent entity. We're planning a mission to attack this thing. I'm asking you for your help.
Say yes, Brian.
I need you to be brave.
If the moon really is what you think it is, suit up.
You have got a big gravity wave coming your way. You have to launch now.
Did he say gravity wave?
We're underwater, guys!
That's crazy.
I hear hurricanes are blowing.
Well, we'll slow down!
What's the plan?
Save the moon, save Earth.
Brian, what are you doing?
It's flying itself!
Wait for it. Let's go, you son of a...
Yes!
Hang on! Everybody, hang on!
I'm gonna get you home!
It's on airplane mode.
All right, boom, there you go. That was the trailer for Moonfall in theaters now, y'all. And as you see on the screen, I'm super excited. I got my man, Eme Ikwuakor. How are you doing today, sir?
Well, I'm doing fantastic. How are you doing, man?
Good, man. Thank you for giving me your time, man. So it's now in theaters. Yeah. People are going to be able to check it out, see all this hard work. And I got to say, man, I had the chance, the luxury to see the film in advance. You bring a lot of the heart and soul into this, man. You know, there's a lot of disaster epicness going on, but the heart comes from you. And you're the military cat, which is also weird. You know what I'm saying? I'm former military.
Yeah.
So it's kind of beautiful that we get a father that is handling business, but also, you know, shows that humanity. What was it like portraying Doug Davidson?
Oh, wow. First off, thank you, especially from like former military to say it in that way. Thank you so much. Playing Doug was an absolute treat. One of the reasons why is because you do have the, you know, the military mindset, A, driven, but at the same time, you have a guy who's kind of playing catch up. And the reason why he's playing catch up is because he's put his career so much on the front that his wife and kid have kind of been on the back burner. And the entire movie, he's really trying to balance that. And because the moon is coming and death is imminent, and you know, what do you say? You know, how do you respond? And how do you reconnect when you have basically very, very, very little time to, you know, I guess, handle your business.
Yeah, I love it. And it just despite everything, we get to see that humanity through your character. So I love that as actor, I'm an actor myself, you know what I'm saying? To have that kind of role, to establish that for a film, especially one that this is a disaster epic, right? Yeah. You get to be that person. That's beautiful. So props to you on that. Tell me about working with Roland Emmerich, the king of disaster films.
Yo, like, you're working with a visionary. When you're doing this, and he's a guy that has such a proven track record that you can just kind of collaborate with him and just like leave it out there. One of the things that I think is really cool is, especially with CGI, is you could kind of play with it in your mind, like how is this going to look? But you know, talking with Roland, he really gave you the parameters of where you can play. And so with a lot of my scenes, especially where I'm at, I'm in this, you know, kind of in a bunker, seeing and really giving the idea of what's happening on the outside is, I give a lot of credit to Roland and the entire team. They gave me so many resources to play with this character, expand with this character, and just give me as much research as possible.
I love it. All right, so now I got to ask Emmy, if you really in this kind of a situation, what is Emmy doing? What are you doing? I know you recently got married. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Props to you on that. Yeah. What are you and the wifey doing with, if this is going down?
You don't want to talk. I'm so dumb with these situations. I'm like the guy that's like, you know what? I could stop the moon. Like, I would literally go outside and be like, look, I'll be safe. Like, put my hand out and be like, I will push you back with like good energy. I'm like, no, I'll be like, I'm like one of those people that would like run outside and trip on a curb and break my neck before the moon even hits. Like, that's, I'm that type of guy.
Well, as much as
I want to say that I would like save, I was like, I think I would save, but I would die in the process of trying to save by doing something stupid.
I'm sure we'd be spending time with our families and just trying to make the most of, you know what I'm saying? What we got to do.
Which should have been my answer. I'm gonna sit down.
And real talk though, so this is NRW, Nerds Rule the World. When I first saw your name attached to this, having only seen brief, you know, trailers and sequences, I was like, hold up, Eme Ikwuakor, that's the brother from Marvel's Inhumans. Is this the crossover we're finally getting? Am I getting Gorgon back? I was like, okay, let me find out. It's good to see you, man.
Yeah, you too. Yeah. Hey, it's similar. We're both dealing with the moon. So
Exactly.
Is this a crossover of Marvels and Humans and Moonfall?
I love it. So what do you want to tell the fans out there that are checking this out right now? In theaters, check out Moonfall. What would you say to them about Moonfall?
Yo, have a blast. You know, we've been in this time with COVID and quarantine, just go out, have some fun, sit back and enjoy, and just really just, you know, fascinated just this, you know, this beautiful thing that Roland did in a time of COVID. So have a blast, bring family and have fun.
Definitely. It's a great popcorn film. You're fantastic in it, Emmy. I know you got some other films coming up soon. I think Gray Man, I believe, is one of those joints coming. How can we check you out, reach out to you online and follow you to keep up with everything you got going on?
Yeah, for me, it's just basically if you type in Ikwuakor, Ikwuakor on literally anything, I'm there. No one else is taking it. If they do, I'm probably related to them. So they can relay the message.
I love it, man. Well, salute to you from a former military cat to a cat that's playing us really well. You held it down from extent to now with Moonfall, man. I love your character's role and what you did in representation for us there. Thank you so much, Emmy, for your time. Really appreciate you, man.
Oh, dude, thank you so much, man. Have a great day, all right?
All right, brother, you too. Yeah. Everybody, check out my man, Eme Ikwuakor, in Moonfall right now in theaters from Roland Emmerich, featuring Patrick Wilson as well as the amazing Halle Berry, y'all. Love y'all. All right.